Good evening. Today we are going to see a problem that is laterally unsupported beam. Already we have seen actually problem of this, but in this problem we are going to see the checks which we have to take while designing a laterally unsupported or laterally supported beam. In previous problems we are not with this one, we have only designed the member till moment of resistance. So now in this we have design a simply supported beam of span. So we have this span 6 meter carrying the factored concentrated load of 315 kilonewton at center. Assume Fe410 grade of steel. Beam is laterally unsupported. Tech bearing length 100 mm. E we have 200 GPa. So now we have first loading condition. Concentrated load is given. So we have to select this section and we have some self weight for that section. And this value is taken as actually 200 to 350. If load is light, then we will go for 350, and that value we are going to increase as our load will increase. For plate girders or built up beams, this value will be taken as 200 or 250. In this, I have taken this value as 315, so that we will get value as 1 kilonewton per meter. We do not have much effect of this, but we have to consider while we are going to design it, because that will affect in plate girders, because there we have span more, load large one, and therefore we should be habitual to consider self weight of the beam. So we have this as 1 kilonewton per meter because dead load is not given. So we have this one. Then we will find reaction, which will be P by 2 plus WL by 2, and we will get it as 160.5 kilonewton. That will be my reaction RA equal to RB. Then we have SFD BMD, so need not require to explain. So we know our maximum shear force is reaction, maximum bending moment PL by 4 plus WL square by 8, and we will have 477 kilonewton meter. And then we have this will be SFD and then BMD, so maximum bending moment 477 kilonewton meter. So now we will select this section here. Actually, I have considered directly 1.9 because bending moment is large one, and then for this one, we are going to get value 3986.66 centimeter cube. And then we will go to the section. So if we will go section, then here we are going to get this ISWB. Generally, we are not using ISWB, but here we do not have any other choice than ISWB. And that we are going to consider 1337. That will be my weight per meter. So we have this value 3986.66. So we have this. Select ISWB 1337 and 3986.66 millimeter cube. RYY, you can see we have 5.25, so 52.5 millimeter. Then we have TF, that is given 21.3 millimeters. And then from this, we will find KL upon R. KL is given 6,114.29. HF upon TF, this comes 27.17. So first we will take trial, is this section is satisfying our requirement or not. Otherwise, we have to go for the next section or other section. So now we have to go for KL upon R, and we have HF upon TF, that is 25 to 30. Now we have this value 110, 120, 251.8, 232.1, 221.2 and 202.4. Now if we will calculate this, then we have to take 27.5, which will be center of this. And then we have 114.29, so center of this 115. So we have 32 and 51, so around 20. So 10 if I will consider, then this I will take it as 242. Then 202, 221, again around 20. So I will consider it as 212. So we have 242, 212. And then if we will calculate center of this, then we have 12, 42. So 30, so 15 if we will add, then we will get it as FCRB, that is equal to 212 plus 15. And this gives us 227. So now FCRB is 227. So we have calculated value that is center of these all four, and that comes 227. And for this 227, we have calculated value of FBD, and that comes 141. So now 227, so around center of this, you can say 225. So 134, 152, So we have 18. If you will add 9 to this, because 19, 18, we have difference between the two. So half of this 9, because we have around 225, and then we will get it as 141 or 143. And from this, we are going to get this value as 562. So it comes actually 143 if we will consider center. So this value we are going to get as 1562 kilonewton meter, which is greater than required 477. So now we will go with selection of sections. Already we have done this. Then we have classification of section. So we have flange is plastic, web is plastic, and therefore section is plastic, beta B is 1. The moment of resistance, now we have to calculate exactly these values, and then we have calculated these values. So 242.91 for 110 and 27.5, and then for 120 and 27.5, 213.04. And from this we will get FCRB 230, and this value is for KL upon R 114.29, and for HF upon TF, and that is equal to 27.17. And for this, we will get FCRB 230. And then for this, we will calculate value of FBD. And then we have this will be 134.1 plus. So difference of these two divided by, we have this as 50 and multiply by 230 minus 200. And it comes 145.02 MPa. And knowing this value, we will calculate MD. And this MD we will get 578.15 kilonewton meter, which is greater than 477 kilonewton meter, therefore satisfied. And then we will go for the check, that is step 7, wave buckling. Now already we have seen this wave buckling, so already I have explained this. So now here we have to go for, so same diagrams I have taken from this, these all steps we have same, which we have seen in last video, and from this we are going to get L by R minimum. Now L by R minimum we have 0.7 root 12 D. So you can take of this, if you will solve this, then you will get this value that is equal to 2.5. So you can go 2.5 D by TW. And then from this we are going to get this value as 129.90. And for this L by R minimum from table 9C, we have to find value of FCD, which comes 74.39 MPa, because 129.9, it is very close to 130, and for 130 we have 74.3, because this value we have for FY 250, and for FE 410 we have to take FY 250, and that comes 74.39. then we have to actually find out value of N1, and that we have N1 equal to 2 into D by 2. Already we have seen angle is 45 degree, and this distance is D by 2. And as it is D by 2, angle is 45 degrees. So D by 2 dispersion we have on both sides of that concentrated load. So it comes D, and therefore it is D 600 millimeter. And then we are going to get area 100 plus 600 into 11.2 into 74.93. Because formula, if you will see, we have B1 plus N1 TW into FCD. And this value comes 583.22 kilonewton, and that is greater than 315 kilonewton. You can find the same way by for reaction also, and that reaction should be less than your value of FCDW. Then we have step 8, wave crippling. So this wave crippling will be at 1 in 2.5, that is given in IS code. So again, we are in the same fashion, we have seen this. So we have B1 plus NW, and now we know if we are at center, then we have value of N2 that is equal to 2 into 2.5 into TF plus R1. And R1 we have for this ISWB 600 from IS 808, this value of R1 we have 17 millimeter. And then we will substitute these values, that N2 is 2.5 TF plus R, and for intermediate concentrated load, this value goes 191.25 millimeter. And then we will substitute this value. And by substituting this value, B1 plus N2 into TW into FYW upon 1.1 comes 741.36 kilonewton greater than 315. And similarly, you can calculate for reaction also. We have value of reaction 160.5. And for that, you can calculate the change we will get. This 191.25, this becomes half of this one, and then also that value comes very large, so we need not require to check at reaction. And last check we have, that is check for deflection. Now as we have concentrated load, we have to take WL cube upon 48 EI, but W, this is, we have serviceability load. And as it is serviceability load, so we have to consider load, that is 385 upon 1.5. We have to divide it, because 385, this is factored load, divided by 1.5. So we have divided, 315 divided by 1.5. And this 1.5 we have taken to make the concentrated load to service load. And then substituting this value, we are going to get value of delta, that is 4.44 millimeter. Now you can see we have other buildings, vertical load, live load we have, then floor and roof. And we have this value, that is elements number